you got a long way to go. Rock with your image is so hot, and you say you got skills in the bedroom. Yeah, try to flirt for you so bad, had to chase you still. Hi guys, why am I making this video? Okay, I have a couple questions for us as a YouTube community. Where is the love? Where is the compassion? And what kind of community do we want to be? I have noticed that maybe the hating was always there, like before I was ever a YouTube member. But let me tell you a little something about myself. I am a very compassionate person. I care about other people. I worry about how other people are doing. If someone's not doing well, or if someone is in a crisis, I worry for them. I care for them. When I see someone making a video talking about something they're struggling with, whether it's, you know, I can't lose any weight, you know, I'm in this bad cycle, or I'm having a bad time, or, you know, there's some people I'm subscribed to who cut, you know, I'm a cutter. There's other people, I'm just normal, you know, I'm depressed, I don't know where my life is going, I don't know what shape it's going to take. I mean, there's people from all different walks of life, and I am personally interested in all their stories, and I'm interested in seeing them get well, I'm interested in seeing them get better, I'm interested in seeing them feel better. So when I watch these videos and someone is in pain or someone isn't doing well, my heart goes out to them. The last thing that I would ever think of doing is to leave someone a hateful comment that might upset them, or to go to their page and leave them hateful comments, or make a video that may or may not upset them. And what people in our community, in the YouTube community, need to understand is not everyone has a thick skin. I have a thick skin. You can hate on me till the sun does not shine, and it will roll right off of my back because I'm a very determined person. I know what I want in life, and I'm very clear about who I am. And it would take a lot for someone who I don't even know to change or, you know, make me think differently of myself. I'm very clear about who I am, where I'm going, and what I want. So when I get a hater comment or a naysayer comment, it has no effect on me at all. Okay, but not everyone is like me. Not everyone has a thick skin. And I don't even know if having as thick of a skin as I do is maybe a good thing. Because there's been some people who've left super nasty comments on my page or on my videos. And my response is, okay, delete, block. And like it like brings up no emotion. So I don't know if that's a good thing or not, okay? I am very aware, though, there's a lot of people in the world and on YouTube who are sensitive. They're very sensitive people. And you need to think before you leave comments or make video responses or leave comments on someone's pages how your comment might affect them or shape them. Because there are some people in the world that are so sensitive that anything anybody says to them shapes them in some way, changes them in some way. And I know I personally do not want to be the cause of someone's depression or making them feel even less than about themselves or hurting someone. I don't want to be responsible for that at all. So you are never going to see comments from me that are not supportive. If I'm watching your videos, if I'm subscribed to you, even if like you make the most negative, depressed video ever, I will try my best to find the most positive thing about that video, and that's what I'll talk about when I leave you a comment. And I'm not telling people, oh, you can't disagree with people. That's normal. It's normal for us to disagree with one another. It's the way you do it. Do you do it with tact? Do you have any class about yourself when you're disagreeing with people? You know, here's a phrase I have for you haters out there. How about this? I respectively disagree with you because of XYZ. There's a concept, okay? I understand we're in the information age. I understand that, you know, almost all etiquette, all protocol is out the window. Okay, fine. But there's got to be some ground rules here. There's got to be some things that should and should not be said. And if they are said, they need to be said in a certain way. And what I notice is a lot of people
who are controversial on YouTube or who have a lot of subscribers, one or the other, they get attacked a lot. But you don't see them making videos attacking other people. You know why? Because they don't have time for it. They are worried about themselves. They're narrating their own story here on YouTube. They're video logging their story. And that's what they have time for. They're not interested in bringing other people down. So, the real question is what type of community do we want to be? YouTube's getting a lot of attention now because of that Time Magazine article. There's been reports on 2020, etc. People are watching this community. What kind of community are we going to be? Are we going to rise above it or not? Now, in the defense of people who have been hated on, me being one of them, when you are attacked, of course you have a right to defend yourself. Of course you do. Sophie Girl said it very well in her latest video. You know, if you bite me, I will bite you back. Okay? Of course you have a right to defend yourself. So if you choose to defend yourself, you have the right to do so. If someone attacks you, you have the right to defend yourself. If they attack you in a text message or in a video, you have the right to respond. Of course you do. To the haters, it will come back on you. When you are sending out all this negative energy, it will come back on you. And just to a community as a whole, have some more compassion for your fellow YouTuber. If you don't like them or understand them, at least either try to or go to the next channel. Stop judging people. Stop judging other people. Why don't you try this instead of jumping to conclusions and hating on people? Try understanding them. That's what I do. Let me try to understand, where is this person coming from? Why is this person doing or saying the things that they're doing or saying? Why? You will never find me judging other people. Because that's just not in my nature. It's not how I believe human beings should conduct themselves. I think you should be more interested in the fellow YouTuber's story. What is your story? Who are you? What are you about? Why do you do and say the things that you do and say? That's what I'm interested in. And I'm interested in showing compassion for my fellow human being. And when appropriate, I'll give them constructive criticism. But it's pretty darn rare that I do so. Because most people already know anything that you're going to tell them. Okay? So you're not going to light up some, you know, light bulb for them by giving them constructive, nasty, hateful comments. You're not. I'm interested in being there for people, being compassionate, being a friend. That's the type of YouTuber I want to be, and that's the type of YouTube community. That would be my YouTube utopia. You know, and I'm not talking about not constructive criticism is valid. It's needed to push you to go forward. You know, you need constructive criticism, but there's a way to do it. And if your whole motivation is just to hate and bring people down, that will come back on you. So, you know, my vow is, and what I'm saying is, and I always have been, I've always conducted myself this way since I've been on YouTube, I'm about the compassion, I'm about the love. What are you about? Because you got a long way to go.